Every AMP page starts with the same basic HTML. We call this the AMP boilerplate. There's no need to memorize this boilerplate. Whenever you start a new AMP page, you can just start with the code at the link in your video description. You can also access a more advanced boilerplate generator at the next link in that video description. For now, let's look at this boilerplate in detail. If this gets too dry, you can always skip ahead to the section on CSS.
First of all, a valid AMP page must start with a doctype HTML tag. It also needs to have an HTML tag with a lightning bolt associated inside of it. That lightning bolt symbol indicates that this is an AMP site. And for those people who don't like emojis, you can actually just use the HTML tag with AMP inside of it, and that's accepted as well.
Like any HTML document, an AMP page needs to contain a head tag and a body tag. The head tag should contain everything shown here. We'll look at this in more detail in a minute.
The boilerplate contains a tiny little sample body for your HTML. Of course, you'd need to replace this HTML with your page content.
Now let's go back to the head. Its first child needs to be meta charset equals UTF-8. That's a standard encoding for extended characters like that lightning bolt.
So this part is really important. Some people actually like to create a non-AMP version of a web page for desktop devices and an AMP version for mobile. This is called the paired approach. But how do search engines know that the AMP and the non-AMP pages are the same content? To make this possible, a valid AMP page needs to contain a link rel to canonical tag. This points to the non-AMP version of your site if one exists. If you simply use the AMP page for all devices, the page should simply point to itself.
Next, the boilerplate needs to contain a meta name equals viewport tag containing content equals width equals device width, minimum scale equals 1. This meta tag helps your site work responsively across devices. It's recommended that you also include initial scale equals 1.
You also need to include the CSS that AMP uses to hide the page content until the AMP JavaScript has finished loading. This gets included in the style AMP boilerplate tag as shown here.
And here's the actual AMP CSS boilerplate. This goes where you just saw that snip. Copy and paste this without any changes. Don't change the values, the order of text inside the tags, or add any spacing.
You'll also need to include this script tag, which loads the AMP runtime. The AMP runtime is the JavaScript that makes AMP work. If you know JavaScript, you'll note that, like all JavaScript in AMP, this is loaded asynchronously for better performance.
You'll also want to include your own CSS in AMP to style your page. This CSS does have some restrictions. First, it must be inside a style AMP custom tag in the head. You can't load an external style sheet unless it's a font. This improves your page's performance as it saves a network request and enables caching. Otherwise, your page can be blocked while the browser is waiting to load that external style sheet. An AMP page may have only one style AMP custom tag, which can include no more than 50K of CSS. You can use inline styles as well, and a handful of CSS rules are restricted. For example, you can't use important because that would let you override what AMP needs to do. Some CSS settings are not allowed. For more information, check the documentation.